गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द ड्रग पोडोफिला। पोडोफिलम फुल नेम इज पोडोफिलम पेल्टेटम एंड द कॉमन नेम इज मे एप्पल एंड मैंड्रिक एंड इट इज बिलोंगिंग टू द फैमिली बर्बरडेशे। देन द पार्ट्स यूज्ड, द टिंचर ऑफ द रूट गैदर्ड आफ्टर फ्रूट हैज राइपेंड, then tincture of fresh plant and a tincture of ripe fruit and a solution of resinous extract. The common name is may apple and mandrake, belonging to the family berberdaceae. This is the plant may apple, and it has got another name, that is mandrake, American mandrake. First we will see the general analysis of this drug. This drug acts especially upon the liver and the digestive tract. It has got a special affinity for mucous membrane and glandular structures, producing in such irritations, excessive secretions, inflammation, and even ulceration or suppuration. The chief feature of podophyllum is a morning diarrhea with a sour green bilious evacuation, and podophyllum is a acute remedy which is mostly given in acute conditions like diarrhea, cholera, etc. Now we can see the therapeutic range of this drug. The therapeutics includes bilious conditions, hepatic affections in general. Podophyllum is a liver remedy, and podophyllum is a right sided remedy also. Podophyllum is a liver remedy. You can remember almost all the liver remedies are right sided. There are few exceptions, but in this podophyllum it is right sided and it's a liver remedy. Then the therapeutic range, bilious condition, hepatic affections in general, congestion of liver, acute and chronic inflammation, gallstones, jaundice, diarrhea, cholera infantum, hemorrhoids. Then for conditions during, complaints or ailments during dentitions, prolapsus anae and prolapsus of uterus, then colic, constipation, bilious fever, dyspepsia, gastritis, and bad effects of mercury. Podophyllum is also called the vegetable mercury is podophyllum, and in conditions of hydrocephaloids. So therapeutic range, bilious conditions, hepatic affections in general, congestions of liver, acute and chronic inflammations, gallstones, jaundice, diarrhea, cholera infantum, hemorrhoids. Then ailments from dentition, prolapsus of anae, prolapsus of uterus, lead colic, constipation, bilious fever, dyspepsia, gastritis, then bad effects of mercury and hydrocephaloids. Then the conditions is bilious temperament. So coming to the constitution, podophyllum is better adapted to persons of a bilious temperament who suffer from gastrointestinal derangement, especially after abuse of mercury and bilious attacks. It's a right sided remedy and a bilious temperament, and person who suffer from gastrointestinal derangements, especially diarrhea condition. But in this remedy there is a characteristic or general symptom, that is alternating states, the diarrhea alternating with the constipation and diarrhea alternating with the headache, and so on. Next symptom is thirst for large quantities of cold water. The same symptom we see in bryonia, the thirst for large quantities of cold water. There are many drugs which have the same symptom, craving for cold water or the thirst for large quantities of cold water, desire for cold drinks, etc., which we see in phosphorus, silica, calcarea, carb, veratrolb, or salp. But there are some peculiarities which discriminate these drugs from one another. Next symptom is pains, which are sudden shocks of jerking pains. The pains comes in shocks or they are of a sudden jerking pains. We are discussing only the keynote features now. Next, coming to the mental picture, the podophyllum patient is always a depressed person, a depression of spirits. And what is the cause for his depression? The cause for his depression is he imagines he is going to die or be very ill. That is the cause for his depression. He imagines he is going to die or be very ill, so that there is a disgust for his life. So next we will be discussing about the head symptom. I have already mentioned there is an alternate state in this drug, that is headache alternates with diarrhea, and headache in winter and diarrhea in summer. Headache in winter and diarrhea in summer. These alternating symptoms of headache and diarrhea we see in aloes also. In aloes we have headache alternation with diarrhea. There are headache alternating with gastralgia, which we see in the medicine called bismuth. Headache alternating with gastralgia. There is a peculiar symptom with this headache. The patient, the podophyllum patient, the headache will be presenting with a head is hot and rolling from side to side. Head is hot and rolling from side to side. This symptom we see in some conditions of cerebral origin or of nervous system complaints like meningitis, hydrocephalus, etc. So the some other drugs also having this symptom, which is indicated in these type of conditions of meningitis, hydrocephalus, etc. The other drugs are Belladonna, Helioborus and Epis. Headache, head is hot and head rolling from side to side. And morning headache and headache with heat in vertex. Headache with heat in vertex. And headache with giddiness and dizziness. And headache rolling from side to side. And headache with morning. Morning. MONING. Headache with morning and headache during dentition or with bowel disorders. Headache during dentition or with bowel disorders. Headache alternating with diarrhea. Diarrhea may be alternating with headache, or diarrhea may be alternating with constipation. There is an alternative stage in this drug. Now coming to the diarrhea. Usually podophyllum diarrhea is painless. Painless cholera morbus and cholera infantum. Painless cholera morbus and cholera infantum. The symptoms of podophyllum diarrhea can be described in PEAS. That is P for painless, profuse, putrid and protrusion of anus. The diarrhea symptoms can be described in 4 P's. That are painless diarrhea, putrid diarrhea, profuse diarrhea and there is prolapse of anus. Painless, profuse, putrid and prolapse of anus. The diarrhea is usually associated with violent cramps in the feet, calves, thighs and watery, painless stools. Diarrhea is associated with violent cramps in feet, as we see in Cupramet, some cholera drugs. Violent cramps in feet, calves, thighs and watery, painless stools. Diarrhea of long standing. And there is a modality, that is more time modality, that is early morning diarrhea. Early morning diarrhea we see in other drugs includes sulfur, Romex, natron sulf, bryonia, etc. Early morning diarrhea. And but in this podophyllum there is a peculiar picture, that is this diarrhea continues through the forenoon and in the afternoon section the patient will be having natural stool. Diarrhea of long standing, early morning diarrhea. Diarrhea continues through forenoon and is followed by natural stool in the evening. Followed by natural stool in the evening. In bracket it is given another term, that is aloes. Then diarrhea is accompanied by a sensation of weakness or sinking in abdomen or rectum. Note, there are so many drugs with sinking feeling in the abdomen. But in this condition there is diarrhea accompanied by sensation of weakness or sickness in the abdomen or in the rectum. In rectum also the patient feels a sensation of sinking or a weakness feeling. Feeling of sinking or weakness in the abdomen. Then it is a very good remedy for children, especially the conditions of diarrhea. डायरी ऑफ चिल्ड्रन as I had already mentioned in the therapeutic range, it is a very good remedy for ailments from dentition. So diarrhea of children during dentition and diarrhea after eating. Diarrhea after eating, but there are so many drugs with these symptom aggravation after eating or drinking. Bryonia, Heppar, Grothendieck, Aloes, all the drugs are having aggravation after eating or drinking. China, etc. Then diarrhea while bathing or washed. Diarrhea while being bathed or washed. Diarrhea of dirty water soaking the napkin too. That is the water the diarrhea is though that much profuse and watery in nature. That the diarrhea of dirty water soaking napkin through. Another medicine is benzoic acid. Benzoic acid is also an important medicine for cholera infantum. But the benzoic acid there will be horribly smelling urine. In this podophyllum patient, this offensiveness is seen in the stool. That is putrid stool. Then diarrhea with gagging, stool green, watery, fetid and profuse. Diarrhea with gagging, stool green, watery, fetid and profuse. And gushing out diarrhea. Gushing of diarrhea, so many drugs are there. Gambogia, Jetropha, Phosphorus, Grothendieck, etc. There are so many color changes we see in this drug. That in diarrhea, there sometimes it may be chalk like, sometimes it may be jelly like, as seen in aloes. Sometimes it can be presented as the stool mixed with undigested particles, so that it looked like a yellow meal in appearance. Yellow meal in appearance. It looked like yellow meal in appearance. So there are so many appearance, chalk like appearance, then jelly like appearance and stool undigested appearance, undigested particles and yellow meal like appearance, as I have mentioned, there are four P's for podophyllum. Podophyllum starts with P and it is an important remedy for diarrhea, and diarrhea can be described in four P's. Four P's are profuse, putrid, painless and prolapse of ani. Then prolapse of rectum or ani before or with stool. Prolapse of rectum ani before or with stool. Next, there is difficult dentition. Difficult dentition with the morning. The same morning we see in condition of headache. Headache with the morning. There is not that in Epis and Belladonna we can see there is a shrieking kind of crying. But in this drug there is only a morning only. Then in teeth complaint, there is grinding of teeth, especially in the night, and there is an intense desire to press the gums together. But difficult dentition, morning, and grinding the teeth at night, intense desire to press the gums together. And podophyllum is a very good remedy in female complaints, especially the prolapse. There are so many drugs which have got very good action, like sepia, murex, liliantic, etc. In podophyllum, all the complaints, all these prolapses which are resulting from overlifting, prolapse uteri from overlifting or straining, and prolapse from constipation, then prolapse after parturition, prolapse with subinvolution. There is another drug, Liliantic. Liliantic, same conditions, this prolapse and all. But Liliantic is a left-sided remedy and podophyllum is a right-sided remedy. Liliantic is chiefly a left-sided medicine. And another symptom, that is in early months of pregnancy, the patient can lie comfortably on the abdomen or stomach. The same symptom we see in acetic acid. But in acetic acid, there is no specificity of the condition. The patient cannot lie on his back. In this podophyllum, the patient even lie on his abdomen in its early months of pregnancy. Podophyllum patient lie on abdomen even in the early months of pregnancy. But the acetic acid patient, they cannot lie on back. So they prefer to be lying on abdomen. Lying on abdomen even in the early months of pregnancy. But there is another drug which cannot lie on abdomen. That its most preferred position is back, that is Arsalp. Can lie comfortably only on back. I have already said that podophyllum is a liver remedy, a right-sided remedy, a liver remedy. But in this podophyllum patient, a characteristic symptom that discriminates it from other remedies, that is, in podophyllum patient, its abdominal region is very sensitive to pressure and there is an abdominal soreness. It is extremely sensitive. But even though the person is very sensitive, we will be seeing the patient will be constantly rubbing and shaking the region of liver with his hand. That the there is a contradiction. The patient's abdominal region, liver region, is very sore to touch and is having very much soreness and is very sensitive to pressure and touch. But even though there is tenderness and soreness, the patient is constantly rubbing and shaking the region of liver with his hand. The patient will be coming to your OP constantly rubbing and shaking the region of liver with his hand. But he says he is having much soreness and sensitive to pressure in this abdominal and liver region. Next, coming to the fever. The most characteristic feature of podophyllum fever is, in fever, the patient become greatly loquacious. That is, he become very talkative, especially in his chill stage and in the heat stage. And during the sweat stage, the patient will be sleeping or with perspiring, the patient has gone to sleep. So sleep during perspiration and in fever stage he will be much loquacious. Loquacity during fever, especially during chill and heat. Then fever paroxysm at 7 a.m. Fever paroxysm at 7 a.m. Then sleeps during perspiration. And next, that it's the side affinity. So there are so many drugs with right-sided affection. Podophyllum is also a right-sided remedies. And chief remedies with right-sided affections are Lycopodium, Chelidonium, Causticum, Bryonia. All these drugs are right-sided. So podophyllum also a right-sided remedy which affects the right throat and right ovary, right hypochondrium. What we see in Lycopodium also we see in it affect the right side, then going to the left side. What we see in Lachesis, there is the affections of left throat coming to right side. There is alternation of right and left seen in Lacaninum. That is seen in alternating stages seen in shifting of changes is seen in Lacaninum. So podophyllum affects the right throat, right ovary, right hypochondrium. Then there are so many right-sided symptoms. Pain and numbness in the right ovary running down the thighs of that side. The same symptom is seen in Lilientic also. But Lilientic is a left-sided remedy. Pain and numbness in the right ovary running down thigh of that side. The remedy is Lilientic. But the differentiation is chiefly Lilientic is a left-sided medicine and the podophyllum is a right-sided medicine. Then suppressed menses of young girls. Other remedies are pulsatile and tuberculum. Then the last section of this keynote features, that is modality. I have already told the diarrhea, early morning diarrhea. So aggravation, generally the old headache is to aggravated during early morning the headache. So aggravation during early morning headaches, early morning diarrhea. Generally, the patient is aggravated in early morning and other drugs are aloes, Nexomica and sulfur. Then aggravation from hot weather and aggravation during dentition. So that's all about the keynote features. And we will be discussing in these drugs regionals and its comparative section in the next lectures. Thank you.